I saw this video on Twitter with over 5 million views, and then again on YouTube with nearly 1 million views. Basically, this guy modified his cell phone case with propellers to take selfies, which is awesome. My only issue with it is that it's not only fake, but it's a scam, which I'll explain in a minute. But as for it being fake, the first clue is that these are 3-volt, 7mm microbrush motors, like you see here. If you attach one to a beam like this and turn it on at full throttle, you'll see the most weight that it can lift is 6 quarts. Or about 30 grams. The cell phone in the video with all the flying gear attached would weigh about 300 grams. And since drones are typically designed to hover at 70% max thrust, you would need at least 15 of these motors to do what he did. But you know, this just doesn't look as catchy. In fact, we recreated the exact setup he used in the video and turned the motors to full throttle, and this is what happened. Here it is in slow-mo, and as you can see, there's hardly any difference than if you don't turn the propellers on at all. So I'm gonna show you how this scam artist somehow manages to break the laws of physics 4 more times in this 3-minute video, and then because obeying the laws of physics isn't optional, we're gonna call up fellow YouTuber Captain Disillusion to see if he can help us spot any signs of special effects. And then, with my buddy Peter Shreepool, I'm gonna show you what it would take to actually build a flying selfie phone case, and then I'll put all the details on a new site I built using Wix.com. But before I do any of that, let me first explain why this is a scam and not just a harmless fake video for meaningless internet points. With this many views and an astounding 80% like ratio, which means most people probably didn't realize it was fake, it's a statistical certainty that some young, aspiring engineer actually tried to build this themselves. Worse than their parents' phone dropping like a rock and breaking, this might have been his or her first experience at making something. But how, you might ask, would they know what components to use? Well, here in the description, Amazing Maker was kind enough to put links. Amazon affiliate links. You can tell by the URLs. So he is making money off the crushed dreams of aspiring engineers without enough experience yet to know that this is total BS. And aspiring engineers are my people. And you don't mess with my people. Let's do this. The second gratuitous violation of physics comes in this scene. The force of gravity always points down, but a helicopter's spinning blades create a force perpendicular to the blades themselves. So if you want to hover, you need to be level so the forces will cancel out and you won't move. If you tilt forward and then break the thrust force into its X and Y components, you suddenly have an unbalanced force that will move you in that direction. In essence, that's how helicopters move forward, by tipping forward. In other words, it's physically impossible to hover in an orientation like this. The forward thrust component is unbalanced, and it would have to move the phone forward. The third major issue is the Arduino-compatible circuit board he chose. It's the same board here, and it's supposed to be the brains for the drone, yet this specific model of board doesn't come with any sort of gyroscope or accelerometer. Here's why that matters. If you've ever tried balancing something on your hand like this, you and your body were creating what's referred to as a closed-loop feedback control system. So if it starts to tip over, my eyes relay that to my brain, and my hand says, hey, I'm no longer feeling the weight just up and down, it's also pushing my hand this way. And so my brain takes all that information and responds by telling my hand to move this way at a specific speed in order to compensate. So to keep this thing balanced, there's this continuous loop of quickly gathering information and then making real-time adjustments. And closed feedback loops are used all over in engineering. From the simple case of a thermostat that continuously checks the air and turns on at a certain temperature, to dartboards that update their position 200 times a second to get a bullseye every time, to machines that are abused, and most certainly for anything that flies and needs to stay in the air. The fact that his board is missing a gyroscope and an accelerometer means there's no way for it to tell if it's starting to rotate or to fall in any direction. It's the equivalent of trying to balance the board wearing a blindfold and an oven mitt. You have no idea what adjustments to make to keep things balanced. Which is the perfect lead-in to the fourth major physics flaw. Notice how he attaches these motors and rigidly fixes them to the phone with double stick tape. This means if you start to tip forward, you have no way to self-correct the phone orientation and it would just turn into a nosedive. If you only have two propellers in this configuration, they both need to be able to rotate with respect to the phone in order to correct for movements in all 6 degrees of freedom. For example, if it starts to tip forward, you could rotate them both back like this to correct for that. Or if the wind is trying to spin the phone this way, they could assume this configuration to counter that. To return to our balancing shovel analogy, by fixing the motors directly to the case, you lose your ability to even make corrections. So not only do you have no idea where to move, but your arm is locked out from making adjustments anyways, which makes it literally impossible to balance.
Ow.
And my final physics issue with this video is one of acoustics. This guy proposes using it as a hands-free way to watch your favorite super hip music videos, conveniently dubbing over the audio here. Maya, 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 Maya. For reference, this is what an episode of The Office would sound like on a phone at full volume. And don't forget, you would actually need 13 more motors than this, so it would be at least 6 times louder. So now that we've thoroughly established a multitude of physical laws have been broken, let's find out exactly how he faked it. And to do that, I've arranged a video call with the undisputed heavyweight champion of debunking fake videos using special effects, Captain Disillusion.
Make sure to get it as flush as possible against your skin to minimize folds that might make it hard to chroma key out, like this. Nice and tight.
Captain!
Oh, hi, Mark. Mark Rober, you weren't supposed to call yet.
It's 2:00. I'm actually even 5 minutes late.
Really? Well then. How can I help you?
Did you not even watch the video I sent?
Yes, of course, the mobile drone video. I've analyzed it thoroughly, Mark, and my conclusion is it's totally real.
Seriously?
Yes. Everything except for the mobile drone part, that's fake. If you look very closely, you might just be able to make out the huge chattering mask on the side of the phone, visible in every shot of it flying. The creator must have been in a real hurry because it's so messy. Here it cuts off the edge of the phone, here the tip of his finger, and here it reveals the thing it's supposed to be hiding, a rod. It's narrow and light-colored, and probably attached with the same mounting tape he used to tack on all the other gadgets. That's why he's able to grab and adjust the phone in this shot. By the river, the mask hides not just the stick, but the whole person holding it. Look closer. On this side, the real-time water, and on this side, a still frame from an empty version of the shot. And if we track the phone's position and rotation, we can easily reverse engineer exactly how the stick puppeteered it, rotating mostly from the point where it was held.
Wow, that was very impressive, Captain D. Thank you for taking the time.
My favorite part of this whole thing is the audio. The tiny propellers must have made so little noise at a distance, it didn't give a proper drone vibe. So the hoaxers recorded the sound of the motors up close and reused the same clip in every scene, complete with their muttering voices in the background.
Awesome. Well, thanks again
for- But even more impressive is the number of posts, messages, and tweets, presumably from people with functioning eyeballs, asking me if this painfully obvious edit is real, over and over.
Okay, Captain, well, take care. I've gotta go back to my-
Even you, Mark! How could you do this to me? How could you do-
He's such a joker. So it's fake. And now you know exactly all the reasons why. But it's still a really interesting idea, and I was curious what it would look like if you actually built one of these using less special effects and more practical engineering. So naturally, I called on my buddy Peter Schriepel, whose qualifications include building his own electric plane from scratch, and he immediately got to work. Turns out if you take 2 brushless motors, 2 electronic motor speed controllers, a flight controller that actually has a gyroscope and an accelerometer integrated, a 3D printed frame and 2 servos to articulate the rotors, a radio transmitter for remote control, and a 4-cell LiPo battery, and then you put them all together, it actually works. Kind of. We had to do a bunch of test flights to calibrate that feedback control loop we talked about before. So if we notice the drone is either undercompensating or overcompensating when it starts to fall in a certain way, we tweak the response sensitivity in between flights until we get to the sweet spot. And I should mention, remember how the motors from the fake video could barely lift only 6 quarters? Well, if you properly size them for the task at hand, they should be able to lift 150 quarters. And so once we felt like we had it in pretty good shape, we took her out for the maiden test flight. In our defense, it was a little windy out there, but as you can see, it could be pretty wobbly at times. The truth is, a bicopter like this totally works, it just isn't a great design choice. The reason pretty much all camera drones are quadcopters is because they're much more stable due to a larger footprint shared between four motors. And by getting clever with the throttle speeds, you can move in all 6 degrees of freedom with no moving parts. So there you go. With solid engineering, you don't need hidden rods or masking and rotoscoping, and Sir Isaac Newton can once again comfortably rest in his grave. So the moral of the story is just don't cheat and lie and scam. I actually considered going a little easier on Amazing Maker, but then I happened to scan some of his other videos, like this knee brace that charges your phone and even powers this flashlight as you walk. In theory. I'll skip the details, but in reality this system would also never work as shown, which is why if you rewind that and stabilize on his hand in the pocket, you see him click a hidden flashlight switch. Thanks for watching.